Can you tell anything different about me?
Oh, I'm sorry, I went the wrong way. There's Linda. There's Pat. And here's me. And we're doing this real quick cause so we can send it to you on the phone. We're at the Dixie Diner.
Welcome to Jerry's Celebration of Life. Jerry wanted to tell his own story, but when the time came, he wasn't able to. So he asked me, younger brother Lane, to narrate this video. Jerry, along with little sister Kathy, picked out these photographic memories. The narrative was based on Jerry's personal journals. This is Jerry's story in his words. I'm Jerry Lee Dixon. I wanted everyone to know that I had a great life. I was so fortunate to do so many things that most people have never had a chance to. I'm the second of five Dixon kids, all including Father Leroy and Mother Dorothy, are born and raised in Oklahoma. Our young family settled in Southwest Oklahoma City where my first memories were made. My very first memory was of my father coming home after the war dressed in his Navy uniform. I was only 3 years old when he walked into the house and picked me up. I had no idea who he was, and I started crying. The next memory was when I was 4 or 5, and my father drove a dump truck which he parked in the front of the house. One day he asked my sister Pat and I to push the starter down while he cranked it, and somehow it got shifted into gear. It took off backwards with my sister at the wheel and me by her side. My father ran and caught up with us before it got very far, but I'll never forget that experience. Soon, three Dixon siblings walked to school each day with older sister Patsy picking on me and I in return picking on little sister Linda. I also remember the neighborhood bully chasing me home a few times. My father got out the boxing gloves and we duked it out. I lost, but he never bothered me again. The highlight of my adolescent years came when we moved to Nakoma Park. The small town was a drastic change from living in the big city. Luckily, there were three other boys my age who lived on the street. We became best friends, spending our summers exploring the countryside when we weren't laughing, joking around, and playing baseball. In the fifth grade, I got my first girlfriend, who had a twin sister, who liked one of my buddies. The three couples got together for a wiener roast, and that included a game of spin the bottle. The loser got to kiss his girlfriend on the lips behind a bush. You could call that the winner got to kiss the girl. Junior high and high school, those years were great for me. My older sister Pat was in high school at the same time, so we got to know most of her friends as well. And I always had a popular girlfriend. Highlights of my high school days were getting the leading role in two school plays and crowning the Valentine Queen. After graduating from high school, my close friend Wayne Brewer and I decided to see the world, and we took off in an old jalopy and headed to New York City. From there, the plan was to work a freighter to France. After arriving with little money left, the people we talked to at the docks were so scary that we headed back to Oklahoma. I had always been artistically talented, even though I was colorblind. So in 1961, I enrolled in the art school at the University of Oklahoma. I had to pay my own way, so I got a job as a busboy at a sorority house. It was a low-level job, which wasn't much fun, but it showed me another lifestyle I'd not been exposed to before. And it paid my way into my next job at the print shop. I was soon modeling men's clothing, which was a lot more fun. Art school was a great creative outlet, and I had a lot of fun making exceptional works of art. We had a wide variety of students, but it seemed like I was the only normal or straight one of the bunch. So I switched to marketing and design and joined the School of Journalism and got my degree in 1965. I headed to Dallas in 1965 and found a fantastic job with a large publishing company who specialized in making yearbooks. I got to travel all over the country conducting seminars. I really enjoyed the traveling until I fell madly in love with my secretary. Marky was beautiful and exotic looking. She had large brown eyes, dark hair, and olive complexion. She was sexy and bubbly, and we were very much in love. We got married in 1969. I was 26 and she was 20. Me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. We stayed friends, but the marriage didn't last, and we divorced in 1972. By the fall of 1973, I decided to retreat to the solitude of Lake Texoma. I began my next lifelong dream of writing wildly imaginative novels, unlike any ever written. I knew that writing would always be my ultimate goal. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky. Moving back to Dallas, I moved in with my great friend Chuck Rankin. Chuck was single and also breaking into the commercial real estate business. We had many wonderful times, and we were always dreaming and talking about when we would be successful. Chuck fixed me up with Jan Yaklin. She was petite, intelligent, and pretty. We were a very good match in many ways. We soon moved into a duplex in a hip area near the campus of SMU. 6 months later, Jan found out she had terminal cancer. And only a short time to live. She needed me, and I wanted to make her last days special. A few weeks later, we got married under a large magnolia tree in Turtle Creek Park. Chuck was the best man, and I mean that in more ways than one. He was always a steadfast friend. 3 years later, Jan passed. Single again, I went back to Oklahoma, then on to Mexico and Guatemala. After that, I traveled through the mountains in Colorado and the far northwest United States. In 1978, I arrived back to Texas just as the real estate market was starting to boom. I went to work as a salesman for a successful builder, which eventually led me to start my own business. I called my younger brother Terry, and he jumped on the opportunity to move to Dallas as my roommate. I helped him get a job. We became friends, even though there was a 10-year age difference. We spent a lot of our free time having fun, playing lousy golf, and exploring all the adventures Dallas had to offer. Then one day, I walked into my sales office, and there was an attractive stranger sitting at my desk using my phone and putting her sunflower seeds on my desk. Her name was Candy Brower, and I'd never met anyone like her before. I was fascinated by her openness and impressed with her directness. We hit it off immediately. In fact, she told me later that after our first date, she had decided she was going to marry me. Candy and her two boys, Wade and Steven, brought me something I'd always wanted, a family. We were married a year later. In 1982, I started my company, Dixon & Associates, Inc. Finally, my dream of becoming a successful commercial broker had come true. Within 3 months, I had my first deals. The market was hot and I needed help. So I went to my brother, Terry. He accepted my job offer, and we quickly learned that our sound-alike names were too confusing for everyone we worked with. So Terry began using his middle name, Lane. Red roses too. Times were good. Nice houses, nice cars, great European vacations, and just having money in the bank felt good. Later, when the real estate market crashed, so did my marriage. Writing was my way to express my dreams, and I was compelled to begin my first novel. I just had to figure out where to do it. Island life fascinated me. After much research, I joined the crew of a 200-foot windjammer sailboat and sailed the Caribbean. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. I knew when we docked on the island of St. John that I had found what I was looking for. Where trouble melts like a lemon drops high above the chimney top. I loved sharing this paradise home with my friends and family who visited very often. I would happily give island tours and snorkeling lessons to whoever dared to make the trip. My small bungalow apartment sat on top of the hill overlooking the town and the bay and the ocean. Heaven on earth.
Uh-uh. High above the chimney top, that's where